Defensive lineman David Tinsley was ready to take the field in his final season for the Blue Hens, but his first snap against Pitt crushed those dreams.
It was a tight end on me, blocking me, man on man, and I kind of separated and tried to escape, and the running back came through the hole, and I reached out and tried to grab the running back, and as soon as I reached out, I felt something kind of pull, and as soon as it happens for the third time, you kind of know exactly what's going on, so I knew at that point that I had probably torn my bicep again.
Tinsley was born with a rare bicep defect. It has affected his football career twice prior to last year's injury.
Basically, I was born with two biceps that didn't connect to my elbow. The typical person's bicep comes and connects back at the elbow joint, and mine just never did. So I had a 30% bicep and a 70% bicep. The other two happened in practice in the spring, unfortunately, but kind of the same type of play. I was trying to separate and escape, and I think one happened on the goal line here, a second scrimmage, and the other one happened some other point during camp. And all three times it was the exact same injury, distal bicep repair, the rarest type, actually.
This type of injury would allow for everyday mobility, but not for playing sports, if not treated. Tinsley was determined to get back on the field and do what he loves.
The strange thing about the injury is that as soon as after it happens, after the initial pull, you could go around and you could turn doorknobs and everything. Your arm might be a little weak, but you could probably hold water, but you could never be able to kind of throw a football as hard as you want to, or let alone get a 330-pound offensive lineman off of you. So I could function everyday life pretty normally, but I could never be able to go into a weight room and lift weights or curl or anything like that. The surgeon told me after the surgery was done that there's no chance, pretty much minimal chance of me ever re-tearing the bicep at all, either one of them, because he did both surgeries, and that I could go and live a perfectly normal life for the rest of my life and be fine.
Because of the number of times this injury has happened, Tinsley is able to explain it as if he was the one giving the surgery.
So the first one, they went in right here, and I tore the bicep, and I continued playing that spring. And then what happens is once you continue playing, the bicep starts to roll up. And the farther it rolls up, the more difficult the surgery is. So we met with the surgeon, and it was a little bit, it had rolled up a little bit farther than he thought. So he went in and he tried his best to get it back to what it needed to be, and he closed my arm back up. And then we our rehab, like everything was fine, but then it turns out everything wasn't, it wasn't fine. So then we had to find another surgeon, and he went in, and that's why I have a much larger incision up here, because he had to go in and put a cadaver piece in and make the surgery successful, which is what he did on the other arm too. Typically when you have a bicep tear, it happens from the shoulder. But having it done from the elbow joint was completely rare. A lot of surgeons told me that if they went in and something went wrong, I could potentially lose feeling in my hand forever. So finding a surgeon that had done it successfully was a task in itself. The guy in Colorado, he worked on a lot of professional athletes, and the Stepman Clinic is known nationwide, I think even worldwide.
As one of four fifth-year seniors on the team this season, Tinsley has much knowledge and experience that he's excited to share with one of the youngest Blue Hen football teams yet.
I think me just being here for 5 years, I just have so much experience through a bunch of different scenarios, and now being kind of the old guy on the field, I can kind of tell them kind of the tips and tricks I've learned throughout 5 years, so I just have a lot of knowledge to give the other players.
After being injured 3 times, Tinsley has experienced many ups and downs in his football career. He understands now how to deal with all of the emotions and is grateful to be back playing the game he loves for one more season.
As soon as it happens, I kind of told myself, I thought that was it. I thought after the third surgery, you think that this was probably going to be the end of the line for you. This time around, I know my body. I've done this. I'm a fifth year guy now. So at this point, I can trust it fully. I feel completely comfortable, and I'm back lifting almost as much as I was before and just trying to compete with some of these young guys out here. So I feel great.
For Under the Lights, I'm Sarah Ehrlich.